Hello and welcome. We all know that protons, electrons and neutrons are the building blocks of matter, right? But are they really the smallest and not separable into some constituents? We also know that opposite charges attract. But what if I were to tell you that there was an experiment at Stanford University where an electron fired at a proton was deflected by the proton? How would you explain that observation? The answer lies in the fact that stuff is made up of atoms, which are made up of protons, electrons, and neutrons, which in turn are made up of even smaller things. These things are called quarks and gluons. Quarks are particles with partial charges. Yes, partial charges can exist and do exist despite what you were told in school. The most commonly known quarks are the up quark with a charge of plus 2/3 and the down quark with a chance of negative 1/3. Two up quarks and one down quark together give the proton a charge of plus 1. This distribution of charge explains the Stanford experiment's results, where the down quark of the proton repelled the electron. It's like you can sneak into the kitchen to get your favorite snack when your grandmother's there, but can't do the same in your mother's presence. This concept of quarks also helps achieve a simplicity in the explanation of things which make up the universe, which is exactly what we strive for in physics. But we're not done yet. Just because our model works doesn't mean it's true. In reality, the proton may contain many other types of quarks, like the strange quark and the charm quark, with their respective antiparticles, because we still need the charge of the proton to be plus 1. Anyway, particles and antiparticles keep annihilating each other. It's a whole mess out there. But like any other family, there's always a binding force provided by a new set of particles known as gluons. More on gluons in my later videos. Keep watching. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe.